The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect those of Access for Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting groups. If you'd like to produce a show, call us at 260-421-1250.
This is Patty Hunter of Patty's Page. Welcome to my TV show. My special guest today here on Zoom, Trevor Hunt. And he is a country gospel singer. So today, Trevor, have I got questions for you? So where were you born and raised?
I was born in Bluffton, Indiana, but I was raised in Bern, Indiana. So that's about 40 minutes south of Fort Wayne. And I attended South Adams High School. So I grew up in Bern.
While you're growing up, who influenced you the most?
Probably my stepdad or my mom. Both of them love music and supported my music as a young kid. And then all my music teachers as well were very supportive of me as I was growing up. And they saw my obvious love for music and wanted to nurture that.
So what started, musical instruments or your voice?
Probably singing first, although I wasn't that good. And then I got into instruments and that was where my real talent lied. But I always loved to sing, so I just kept working at it and eventually got good enough to sing in front of people. At least I'd hope to think so.
You sing at church?
Yeah, sometimes. I led worship for a church for quite a long time. And then with my shows that I play on the weekend, it's a lot doing worship on Sundays and then also playing Friday and Saturday every weekend. So if something had to give, I stepped out of the worship position and went back into playing live shows instead, just because I'm more of a performer and that's what I really love.
Is that why you got the cold?
Yeah, that's probably why. That or my son gave it to me, one of those two.
How old is he?
My son's 11 months old.
Oh, marvelous. Congratulations.
Yeah. Thank you.
And your wife as well.
Thank
you. Especially her.
Yeah.
So when you went to school, what did you major in, dear? I think I already asked that.
Nope, you didn't ask that. I went to school for elementary education, so I work with kindergarten through fifth grade kids. And I teach them music. I'm actually sitting in my music classroom right now. This is my 9-to-5. I teach kids how to sing and play instruments so that hopefully they can do what I do one day as well. Play on the weekends.
I love teaching. Yeah. I'm not a teacher, but I have my 13 years of Patty's Page. That's like teaching my audience new things, new ideas, you know.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, your first instrument, what did you play? Piano or guitar?
The first real instrument that I picked up, played, and stuck with was the guitar at 15 years old.
Bass?
Just acoustic guitar. Yep. I actually have that guitar right beside me, if you'd like to see it.
Yeah.
Give me 1 second.
Okay, 1 second's up. You're working on it with your coat? Oh, beauty.
This was found in my parents' attic. It was, I think it's worth like $50. Oh. This is my...
It's more than $50 if that is a lot more nowadays.
Yes. Well, with the inflation, everything's worth more nowadays.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Do we get paid the same? No.
No.
So what age did you start to test your voice?
The first thing I ever did as a performer was in fourth grade. I entered a talent show and I entered like an adult talent show and I got pretty far in it. I got through like the first two cutoff rounds, and I remember when I was a kid, I thought, whoa, I just beat like adults, you know, like grownups, I got farther than them. So I was like, this should probably be something I stick with.
Join up the Voice. Did anyone ever ask you if you'd like to go on the Voice?
I've actually tried out for the Voice and I almost got on the Voice last year. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you watched last season with Sam Harnish, but they were
out. I had him as a guest several times.
Okay, so it was down to two people they were going to pick from Fort Wayne, and they chose Sam. So it was me or Sam. I was in the last, like, 100 people, and they have 75 try out. Mm-hmm. So, like, I was just one of the 25 that didn't make the cut.
Oh, you did good. Your voice is beautiful.
Thank you.
And your good lyrics, too. You do your own writing up here.
Yep. Write my own songs. Yep.
What genre are you?
Normally country music, rock music, and Christian music. So I kind of play all three. Mm-hmm. Whenever I play on the weekends, it's mostly country and rock. And then I like bring the message along in a lighthearted way. And then if I lead worship, it's obviously Christian worship music.
Is it contemporary?
Yeah. Yeah. If it's on WBCL, we'll typically do it as long as it's not too crazy.
I do write my own lyrics as well, inspirational.
Yeah, you showed me some of those. Those are really good.
Are they?
Yeah, I like them.
And you've collaborated with many people with your singing?
Yeah, so if you look at my YouTube channel, everyone else in the videos are typically members of my band. So, like, there's the tall guy that's in my videos, his name is Kyle. He's a performer from Disney. And he's my brother-in-law. So he worked for Disney World and Universal Studios for like 20 years as different character actors, sang there professionally. That was his full-time job.
Voiceover?
Like on the stage. He was like Gaston in Beauty and the Beast on the stage. So he came back to Indiana and started singing with my band. And then the drummer and the guitarist are the other two members of the band. And we call ourselves Trevor Hunt and the Sleepers. That's our band name.
Sleepers. That's interesting. Yeah. What's with the Sleepers?
It's a funny story. My drummer is an anesthesiologist. So one day jokingly I said, "Hey, you make people sleep. We should be Trevor Hunt and the Sleepers." And he and everyone else fell in love with it. So the band wanted to keep the name.
Oh my goodness. How long has your band been together?
Like officially as the Sleepers for like 2 months, because we just picked the band. But we've played together for over a year and a half. I've played solo for roughly 4 years now.
Where do you normally tour? Do you tour nowadays?
Yeah, absolutely. All over Indiana and Ohio. I've played down in Tennessee. I've played all over the Midwest, mainly Indiana, just because there's plenty of music in Fort Wayne. Yeah. Because of Sweetwater Sound, there's a great music scene here. So I play mostly in Indiana, but I do some shows in Ohio as well, along the lakes.
When you do it at Sweetwater, how often do you go there to do a gig?
So I don't normally play at Sweetwater. I was just saying because of Sweetwater and their influence on our music scene around here, it's not a bad place to live as a musician.
What's your favorite genre? Country? Gospel.
That's hard because I really do love all types of music. My favorite genre would probably be rock or country music as mm-hmm. far as what I like to perform. Although I do love listening to like orchestral music and classical music as well in my free time because it's not what I perform. And I
it's
like
something different.
Yeah, it keeps things fresh.
What happened during COVID?
So COVID is actually when I started this journey as a musician. So I called 72 restaurants in 2018 and 71 of them told me no, that I couldn't sing for them. Mm-hmm. And I played for one restaurant that year and that one gig led to me booking like 20 something gigs for COVID year 2019. I was super excited and February rolled around and they all got canceled. So instead of getting down on myself, that I couldn't perform, I started learning how to record myself in my home studio, and I wrote Indiana Home and recorded Indiana Home.
Well, we're going to play that. We're going to play that in a sec. Do lead into it. Why did you write it?
I wrote Indiana Home. I actually started to write Indiana Home because I wanted to write a song about all the reasons I hate Indiana. But then as I sat down to write the song, it ended up becoming all the reasons I love Indiana. My family, small town, the field that I grew up in front of. I grew up on a farm, and so we were surrounded by fields, corn and beans. And so looking around at all that, I was like, I love this place. I love where I live. And that's why people have asked me why I don't like try the Nashville thing or, the LA thing. I don't want to leave. I love my family, and I prefer family over like fame and fortune.
So we are going to lead into this. The first song is called Indiana. What's it called?
Indiana Home.
Indiana Home.
Yep.
And we'll be back in a sec.
Yeah, that's gorgeous.
So that was beautiful. 3 minutes of music there. I loved it.
Thank you.
I liked it. And the second song, what's it called again?
I Won't Back Down.
I Won't Back Down either, you know?
Yeah.
That will be played. So I'll be right back in a sec. Well, that was a good 3 minutes too. We love that. I won't back down. Where'd you get this idea? You won't back down again?
Honestly, Tom Petty is one of my biggest influences, and his version of the song I absolutely loved. Honestly, it's a statement of my faith in my heart, like in a culture that is growing increasingly hostile towards Christian and conservative beliefs. I'm not going to back down from what I believe. I'm conservative. I'm Christian. I'm pro-life.
You're pro-life too?
Absolutely. I'm pro-life. I believe every life is important and special, especially after seeing my own son born. My son took his first breath in my arms. And so I would say if any woman could see that and any man could see that moment, then they would definitely change their mind if they are pro-choice. They just got to get to that moment, go through the difficulties of pregnancy and what that means.
You have to get past this death culture, kiddo.
Yeah.
I have 3/4 of my shows are pro-life because I'm with Lutherans for Life myself.
Awesome.
And we have Right to Life in Northeast Indiana here in Fort Wayne. And yeah, I'm so glad you're pro-life because, amen, brother, you stick together.
Amen.
Amen. yeah, CDs out, DVDs, and all that sort.
Actually, I have not released a CD. Everything that I've done has been like on YouTube as far as that goes. I'm working on getting an official album recorded, but as you know, recording is not cheap. And I really want to go through Sweetwater since they've been such a blessing to our music industry. And so I would love to do a collaboration with Sweetwater in the near future on a 12-song album.
Sweetwater is good.
Yeah.
With COVID, you never got it, did you?
I actually got COVID.
Oh.
Yeah. My whole family did.
Oh, dear.
But we were all pretty fine as far as that goes. Nobody passed away. I'm obviously here today talking to you. And totally vaccinated, so hoping to never get it again.
I had it 4 times.
4 times?
3 years.
Oh my gosh.
Anyways, I'm getting older, you know, you get more parts wear out, they say. That's true.
Yeah.
Are you touring now? Anywhere special?
Yeah, actually, I have a show on Friday. This Friday at Auburn Brewing Company in Auburn.
Oh, Auburn.
Yeah. And then I have a show on Saturday at Heartland Winery in Ashley, Indiana.
Oh, you're getting there, eh?
Yeah, I'm playing a lot.
Do you play around in Fort Wayne?
Sometimes in Fort Wayne, but honestly, the Fort Wayne music scene is more of a hard rock and like DJ scene or specialized scene like salsa and not a lot of country music played in the city. At least from what I've heard, I've never seen a live band playing like country standards like I play.
There used to be Spur, Rusty Spur.
Yep.
That's not there anymore, is it?
No, there's a new country bar. I think it's called Knockin' Boots. I just don't, I get so many calls, phone calls for shows that I don't ever like reach out anymore because I'm lazy.
I like you. So, you know, this is towards the end of the show, my friend. I'd like to have you on again.
Sure. Yeah, absolutely.
This is Patty Hunter. Thank you so much, Trevor Hunt, for being on my show. We enjoyed you immensely. And we will enjoy your songs today. And may God bless and may we see you people next week.
Big wheels keep on turning, carry me home to see my kin, singing songs about the Southland. I miss old Bamia once again, I think it's a sin, yeah.
and I heard on you and put her down. Home New Young will remember, and the Southern man don't need him around anyhow. Sweet home Alabama, where the skies are so blue. Sweet home Alabama, Lord, I'm coming home to you. Your conscience bother you? Now tell me true, sing it with me now. Sweet home Alabama, where those skies are so blue and the governor's true. Sweet home Alabama, Lord, I'm coming home to you, Alabama.
Us always for the rest of our lives.